please subscribe to my channel and stick around till the end of the video so you can practice what you learn here and take the quiz. Today I'm going to show you how to pronounce long words in English. It's really not as hard as you think. Just apply some basic word stress rules. The key is in the end of the word. Word endings usually give you a clue as to how to stress longer words. Longer words in English are generally formed by adding word parts to a root word. If you add a part to the beginning of a word, it's called a prefix. Prefixes usually change the meaning of the root word in a predictable way. One of our most common prefixes that you've probably used many times is un. It makes something the opposite. Add un to happy and it becomes unhappy, which means you're not happy. Add un to able and you have unable. Able means you can do something. Unable means you can't. Here's another common prefix, re. It means to do something again. Add re to do and you have redo or do it again. Add re to view and you get review. View is to take a look at something and review is to look at it again. When we add something to the end of a word, that's called a suffix. Suffixes usually change the part of speech. You can make a verb into an adjective. For example, add full to help and you have the word helpful. We can make a verb into a noun. Take decide and you can turn it into decision by adding the ending s-i-o-n. You can turn a noun into an adjective. Nation becomes national by adding an al at the end. And it's really common to change an adjective into an adverb by adding ly. Slow becomes slowly. So when you run across an unfamiliar word, first break it down into syllables. And then take a look at the end of the word. If you're not familiar with the concept of syllables, please take a look first at my video, How to Stress English Words. Okay, so the suffix or suffixes on a word will tell you how to stress the word. You stress the syllable just before the ending for the majority of suffixes. Not all, but for many. Let me repeat that so you really get it. Primary word stress is most often on one syllable before the suffix. Some of the more common prefixes that follow this pattern are t-i-o-n, i-b-l-e, i-t-y, i-o-u-s, u-a-l, l-o-g-y, and i-e-n-t, and there are many others. Follow the link in the comments section below to get a free list of suffixes that follow this pattern. Let me give you some examples. Take the word information. It has four syllables. In, fur, may, shun. The suffix is shun, T-I-O-N. So primary stress is just before that syllable. It's on may. Information. Information. How about this one? Technology. It's also four syllables. Tech, na, la, gy. Here, the suffix is l-o-g-y. So stress is before that on the syllable na. Technology. One more. Opportunity. Five syllables in this one. Opportunity. Opportunity. The suffix is ity. So stress is on tune. Opportunity. Now here's your quiz. First, separate each word into syllables. Second, identify the suffix ending. Then determine where to stress the word. Here are your words. I'm only going to say them once, so you'll probably need to watch this video several times so you can really get the stress patterns. Individual. Impossible. Responsibility. Convenient. Financial. Make sure to check your answers in the comments section below and say them out loud to train yourself to pronounce the stress correctly. Thanks for watching!